Hey, my name is Irina. Welcome to Using Vite Ruby. Ruby is powering some of the main applications that you're using every single day, including GitHub, Stripe, Figma, Shopify, Intercom, and of course, Stackblitz. And it's not just those big existing companies, but also a bunch of startups are choosing Ruby and Ruby on Rails every year. And this is just a small selection that I spoke to in preparation for my RailsConf talk this year. But people, they choose Ruby and Rails as the language and the framework specifically optimized for developer happiness and developer productivity in building web applications. But this productivity and this happiness has to include front-end, right? So in terms of the front-end, Rails has a few different options. One is dual stack or the API only mode of the Rails application that then integrates through this API with the front-end application, React, Svelte, Vue, Astra, etc. In recent years, in the search for productivity and efficiency, people started using this new Rails full stack HTML over the wire technology, Hotwire and Turbo stimulus. And there's its own component systems, its own component approach to components, Vue component or Flex. Now there's also a mixed approach where many companies find that it's nice to be able to build simple CRUD style UI with Hotwire or and maybe Vue component, but then they also want to be able to add React or Vue when they want it, when let's say the data model on the front end becomes more complex, and this is when they want to either substitute just one Vue with React, or they just want to kind of plug a single or a couple of React components into a Hotwire frontend. And people use Inertia.js or similar technologies, and we built a Turbo Mount for that. So this complex frontend comes with a complex set of build tools, of course. And this is the talk from this year's RailsConf by Marco Roth, where he was reminiscing about looking at all the different build tools that we've been using in Rails community over the years. And I'm going to say all those tools are definitely still used by a bunch of Rails applications this day, because we're not only starting new projects, we are maintaining and growing and developing existing successful products and in existing successful businesses, right? I also remember when I was learning Rails myself, problems with asset pipeline and Webpacker were the hardest, something where I could have died probably. A little bit about myself. I'm Irina Nazarova. I run this company, Evil Martians. We are a consulting company for startups, and we focus on a few areas. Products for developers that we love to design and build. Yeah, startups on Rails that we love to grow and help scale. And then real-time and collaboration-heavy apps or tricky collaboration features that we help build. And finally, local-first apps. I see our role in this community as the company that is building the missing tooling specifically for startups and specifically in open source. And this is how many people know us as authors of PostCSS and Autoprefixer, but also Image Proxy, Left Hook. We open sourced our Martian Mono font. We built OKLCH color picker and a bunch of two big WebSocket products, AnyCable and LogX. Now, the asset pipeline is hard, but it's it was definitely a red flag for me when inside of Martians, people would say something like, hey, we need a front ops engineer here. So like a normal Martian front end is not enough. We need a special person to fix kind of asset pipeline problems. So it kind of means that we're not helping ourselves as an industry, don't you think? The author of Rails, David Heinemeier Hansen, definitely agrees, so much that last year he announced that no build is going to be the new mainstream for the new versions of Rails and the new applications on Rails. And yes, no build is definitely faster than any build tool that exists or going to be existing, but it's just a great illustration of how much people are fed up with the problems with the build tools and asset pipeline. And well, you could say, who am I to contradict or disagree with the author of the framework? But we just have a different experience at Evil Martians. So this is just an example, a story from last week. Somebody reached out saying that, hey, I was not able to deploy my application to Heroku because import maps, no build, are not loading properly. And the problem is hard, and I can definitely relate to that. Now, we believe no build is not the solution. And what does the ethos of Rails tells us about this problem and how to solve it? So there's a bunch of build tools, and we see that the innovation here is not stopping, that probably there are going to be new tools, and migrating every single time is just too hard. It's not possible. So the ethos of Rails says that, well, there's a missing layer of abstraction here. There has to be an abstraction that provides amazing developer experience to the application, but then handles all the hard work of integrating with particular build tools on its own, kind of hiding this complexity from the application so that we also don't have to migrate to a different build tool every time something new is built. So, and this is what Vite is for us. And Vite and Vite Ruby are the technologies that we advocate for because we believe, yes, this is the right solution because, yes, we have the best developer experience and we also abstract from having to integrate with each tool, with ES build, roll up to date. And tomorrow is going to be something else. So let's use Vite, and we are building turbo mount and inertia JS generators as part of this Vite plus Rails ecosystem because we believe in it. And here, of course, I want to give a shout out to the author of Vite Ruby, Maximo Mussini, who's been speaking at ViteConf a couple of years ago. Check this out. He's done amazing job in integrating Vite into the life cycle of assets inside Rails. So back to that story from last week. Of course, we are consultants and we could have charged money for helping this person, but we just said, look, take a look at Vite Ruby. You might be able to solve it. And the same day, we got this message. Hey, I was able to solve it in just a couple of hours. Thank you so much. Yeah, and this is what Vite Ruby is for us. And I'm just going to share a few more stories, a few more quotes from our customers at Evomotions who chose Vite and Vite Ruby, and specifically Vite Ruby, and why they did so. Power Home Remodeling Group is a huge billion-dollar revenue Rails company. And they chose Vite because they needed faster compilation of their assets. And at their scale, it's definitely makes sense. It's super important. ClickFunnels, another big, like over $100 million dollar revenue company doing marketing SaaS. The guys have very complex setup with different front end technologies, different front end approaches. And they use both Vite and Vite Ruby. And the main thing they say, or we're not thinking about it anymore because it's just works. This startup summit says that Vite brought them the hot reloading for stimulus controllers for Rails full stack, which is great. Recognize said, yeah, Vite combines the best of Rollup and ES Build. And at Evil Martians, we also love the ability to build plugins. So when we have a particularly complex situation, something like, okay, we have to load assets from inside certain gems or something complex like that, we can always write a custom plugin and use it. And it's just going to be a maintainable solution. And finally, Evil Martians, our customers, and just people in the community say that Vite and Vite Ruby are a joy to use. And this says everything to me. Now, I'm going to share a little bit about, I was asking what's missing. And I got to say, there's not much, but there's something. So first of all, incremental builds and build cache out of the box. This exists as a plugin, but this company said they would appreciate this being available out of the box, or maybe a more clear guidance. Somebody said they had problems or issues with setting up two different entry points. The integration with Vitest, between Vite Ruby and Vitest, could use some love, somebody said. And finally, somebody pointed that the updates of Vite Ruby Jam sometimes are a little bit delayed. But that's that. And I'm going to say, we, again, love the developer experience of Vite, and we believe it matches the ethos of Rails really well. And it's kind of a missing piece for the productivity that we want to see in for startups building with Rails. So that's it for today. Thank you all who's building out the Vite ecosystem, Vitest, and thank you for having me today. Thanks so much.